be here, isn't it? How many of you are ready to see the kids? The baby parade, all this stuff. The baby parade, preschool choir. I'm going to invite Pastor Rob to come, our children's pastor. Let's give him a hand. We appreciate him so much.
Good morning. So wonderful to see your smiling faces.
Yeah.
I really appreciate you coming out and supporting the kids today. We've got a great day. We've got a baby parade getting ready to start here in just a moment. Then that'll be followed up by two preschool songs, and then we will go into our elementary musical, which will be the duration of the service. So just so exciting. Yes.
I forgot to tell you one thing. We are videoing this service. So parents, if you want to get a copy of it, we'll be helping you to do that next week. So I forgot to tell everybody that. I knew I was forgetting something.
No, that's good. I'm glad. Yes, we are videoing this. Awesome. That's so exciting. Well, without further ado, I want to encourage you to definitely give an exciting round of applause for our babies that were coming up. And I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. All right, let's go. All right. Preschoolers, I want to thank you parents who serve in the nursery and preschool.
Yeah.
Man, I tell you what, it is wonderful.
Amen.
Our nursery and preschool is a co-op, so every parent serves once a month. And, I know a lot of people, they go back into nurseries and they think about changing diapers and things like that. But man, really honestly and truthfully, it is a place where we have the first and foremost opportunity to invest Jesus Christ into children's lives. You know, out of all the people that kids are going to meet in their lifetime, over 10,000 people the average person meets in their lifetime, okay, you can be one of the first to invest in their lives. Nursery and preschool is an awesome place to work, and if you want to be on a winning team, be a part of our nursery and preschool ministry, okay? Well, without further ado, our preschoolers are coming in. This is our 3 to 5 year old group. They're coming on down, and they are going to be singing us a couple of wonderful songs this morning. Miss Lynette, Miss Sandra, and Miss Connie, our leadership.
Thank you.
Cassandra.
Not that direction, guys. That's the way you want to go.
Good, good. Beautiful, beautiful.
Take a quick moment before we begin with our elementary musical, and I want to introduce somebody to you. Miss Sandra, if you'll come up here real fast. This is our new early childhood director, Miss Sandra Morgan. Her husband's name is Jamie. You might have seen him on security, and then their son's name is Will.
Yeah.
Oh, here's Bailey right over here. That's right. So I just want to welcome her to our team. She's been with us now a little over a month, and it's been a blessing, man. I'm so excited for everything that's going to happen back in the nursery and preschool. Can you give her a round of applause for all the work she did? Without further ado, I want to welcome you to our kids' Christmas musical.
Yes.
Thank you.
almost Christmas. Yeah, only two more days till Christmas, and only one more day until we get to put on our show on Main Street.
This is so cool. I bet we'll have lots and lots of people there, because the stores will just have closed. Uh-huh.
And all those people buying all those last-minute gifts will walk over.
Speaking of gifts, does your family open presents on Christmas Eve, or do they make you wait until Christmas morning?
We open them on Christmas Eve!
Yay! Oh, you're so lucky. At my house, we have to wait until Christmas morning.
Oh!
We have to wait until all the grown-ups wake up.
Oh!
And finish breakfast.
Oh!
And sip their coffee.
Oh!
The manger scene is a bit old-fashioned.
What? No, it's not.
Well, you can't argue with public opinion, especially with my re-election coming up. Sorry, kids. But hey, say hello to your parents for me and remind them to get out and vote. Well, it's a busy time for me, kids. I gotta go. See you later. Bye.
He can't do that. We've been planning this for months and all those rehearsals.
Well, I guess he can, because he just did. We need to find another place.
No, we can't. It's too late. I don't care what the pole said. I don't even know what a pole is. Let's get everyone here in the neighborhood to help. You know, to call the town hall so he to change his mind.
Yeah, that's a great idea. But how do we reach everyone in time? Tomorrow's our show.
Hey, I have an idea. Let's all go Christmas caroling right now.
Hey, yeah. Hey, yeah, we can go door to door and get all the neighbors to help. The show must go on.
Yeah!
Let's set out on Main Street. We can find a bunch of people there. Our show has a message that everyone needs to hear.
Wow, look over there. That house has the fanciest decorations I've ever seen.
Look how bright and cheery it is. It's all decked out for Christmas.
I'm sure whoever lives there loves Christmas, and they would love our show.
Well then, ring the doorbell. Religious at Christmas time. Ta-ta! I hope they don't come back later and trample on our beautiful decorations.
Or I'll sue them if they do.
Wow, that was so weird.
What do you mean?
Why do they have all those decorations and lights if they don't like Christmas?
Oh, they like Christmas. It's Christ they have a problem with.
Is it a Scrooge thing? No. Careening thing? No. Carousing thing? No, no, no.
Caroling, that's it. I got it. It's much better than music at the mall.
Sure we will do that. We go to all the holiday things all around town. We celebrate all the holidays too.
Flag Day.
Earth Day.
Mardi Gras. Wouldn't want to leave any out.
Wouldn't want to hurt anybody's feelings.
Besides, who knows if Christmas storms right?
Gotta keep your bases covered, bros.
What? What? Are you serious?
Well, the mayor, he canceled our pageant in the square tomorrow. We would like it if you would call the town hall and ask them to let us do it.
Please?
That doesn't, like, seem fair. Everybody should get to do what they want, no matter what they believe. We'll call. Bye-bye now.
Thank you.
we need your help.
What, children? What can I do for you?
Well, we were supposed to do our pageant in the square tomorrow.
Oh yeah, we saw the signs. We're planning on being there.
Well, right now it's been canceled. The mayor won't let us do it.
What?
Yeah, the mayor said the town would be too busy, too much traffic.
He also said he was re-election issue and he didn't want anything with a major scene. It isn't hip and happening enough.
No major scene? But that's where the story of Christmas began, with the birth of Jesus. He knows that.
Will you call the town hall and ask him to change his mind?
I sure will. This is way too important.
Yeah, you just wouldn't believe how many grown-ups don't know about Jesus.
We've just got to tell them.
Yes, you do. Don't worry, kids. I'll call down there right now. I've got a good connection down at Town Hall. Thanks, boys and girls. God bless, and I'll see you tomorrow night at Town Square on Main Street.
It's gonna take a miracle for that to happen.
Christmas is all about miracles.
Wow. Wow, that lady
was so different than anyone else we've met today.
I liked her.
Me too.
She sparkled.
She didn't need Christmas decorations on her lawn. She sparkled on her own.
Came to him.
I know where you live. Well, she's my pride and joy. She said all she wanted for Christmas was to see me in the pageant, at the pageant in the square. Well, I may lose a few votes over this, but boys and girls, it's back on. You can use the square.
Yay!
Thank you. I can't believe today is finally here. We get to do our pageant.
I can't believe there's so many people here. And look, there's the man and his daughter right in the front row.
It's another Christmas miracle!
I wonder how many people we sent to will actually come.
How many people are there?
1, 2, 3.
Gazillions, come on, let's get started. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Main Street Christmas pageant. The birth of Jesus took place over 2,000 years ago, and they didn't have any cell phones or pagers, so turn them off. Yeah. Please. Merry Christmas.
Peace. Good.
Outstanding, boys and girls. You know, I think it's been 20 years since I've heard that story, since my daughter was little and in those things. I've gotten so distracted by all the malls and the music. Seems like that stuff gets started earlier and earlier every year.
You know why that is, Daddy?
Why, baby?
Because this old world is so hungry for the message of Christmas that they can't get it soon enough. One of these years, malls are going to start decorating for Christmas right after the 4th of July. The world just gets the message of Christ and the shopping and gift-giving thing confused. But boys and girls, you made the message of Christmas crystal clear tonight.
You know what? I don't care if I do lose votes over this, but I think the community needs to hear this story every year. And boys and girls, you know what? Next year, I want to be in the pageant. I want to be a wise man. Can I audition? Well, it's Christmas Eve, and I'm sure your families are waiting for you. But you know what? No gift will be as precious as the gift that you've given us here tonight. You kids stood up for what you believe, and you told us what we all needed to hear.
I think we just witnessed a real Christmas miracle. Another incredible, wonderful, beautiful Christmas miracle.
There we go. Let's give the kids another hand. Didn't they do a great job? Man. Great job, kids. You guys did so awesome. I know they've worked so hard. They started practicing back in August or September, right around in there, with a great message of Christmas. And this morning, that really is, they did a great job performing, but the truth of it is the message that they spoke over our hearts. Can we bow our heads across this place? I want to just take a moment and bring the house lights up just a tiny bit if we can. But if you're here in this place and this morning you just say, Pastor, you know what, I don't know who Jesus is. And that really is what the message is of Christmas is all about, is what Jesus came. He came to set us free. He came to be our Savior, the true message of Christmas. And this morning, I want to give you an opportunity. If you've never given your life to the Lord, or maybe you're away from God and you just say, today, Pastor, I need to make that decision. The kids have sang such a great gospel message today. They've spoke truth to us about the fact that the Bible tells us that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And all we have to do to receive that eternal life is reach out. And the Bible tells us to believe in our hearts and confess with our mouth that Jesus is our Savior. And the best gift this Christmas is turning your life over to Him and saying, Jesus, today my life is yours. I give you my life. That's what the kids were singing about today. They were singing about how amazing our Savior is. If you just say, Pastor, today I need to make that decision. I need to make a decision to give Jesus my life. If you're here and you say, that's me, I'm going to give you that opportunity. If you just slip up your hand right now, if you just say, hey, today I need to make that decision to invite Jesus to come into my heart. Thank you. Anyone else that's singing about Christmas, if you're saying today, I need to make that decision, we want to give you that opportunity. Anyone else today? Can we pray together? Can we do that? Jesus, please come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. I give you my life, every aspect of my life. Today I say, you drive and I'll ride. I give my life to you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, today I just pray over this crowd. God, I just pray that your Spirit would just surround them this Christmas. And Lord, if people are making decisions to follow after you today, God, I know that many did across this place. And Jesus, I just pray, Lord, that you would just touch their lives, Lord. God, that hearts would be turned towards you. Father, we thank you for what you've done for Christmas. Jesus, that you'd come for us. Lord, help us to never forget. And Lord, in this world that we're living in, where people are literally afraid to talk about Christmas, I pray that you give us a boldness. Lord, a boldness to stand up for you. And Lord, to not take the Christ out of Christmas. Lord, I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Can we give the kids another hand? Didn't they do such a good job today? Shelly and Pastor Al.
Alright, I just wanted to take a second. Miss Paula, can you please come up here? Miss Paula was the director of this awesome group of children this year, and I can't tell you how much we appreciate her. She just really was a great example. And yeah. Alright. 2 Samuel 2:6 says, may the Lord now show you kindness and faithfulness. And I too, me, Shelly, us, all these kids, all these parents, I too will show you the same favor because you have done this. And we appreciate you. We love you. We've got some flowers for you. And there's a little card. And there's some stuff.
All right. Well, I want to thank every parent that was involved, every sound and light person, media person that was involved, everyone that helped with the sets. We had multiple people help with the sets in this Christmas musical. I just want to thank all of you kids. I want to thank you. You did a phenomenal, phenomenal job. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you for being here today. I appreciate you staying. Hey, if there's any donuts left out there, take them with you because I don't want to eat them the rest of this week, all right? God bless you and have a wonderful, wonderful week.